CQ, the South Central Area Net. This is KA9OPL, Kilo Alpha 9, Oscar Papa Lima. My name is Joe. I'll be serving as net control for this session of the South Central Area Net. Net meets every Tuesday evening beginning at 8:30 p.m. local time on this frequency, which is the Columbus Amateur Radio Club repeater, on a frequency of 146.79 megahertz, using a minus offset and a PL tone of 103.5 hertz. That meets for the purpose of passing traffic, promoting good fellowship among amateur radio operators, and practicing net procedures. This is a directed net. Please direct all communication through net control. Once again, net control this evening is KA9OPL, and my name is Joe, located here in Columbus, Bartholomew County. At this time, do we have anyone holding emergency, priority, or welfare traffic? Please call. Please alert me with the words break, break. I will assist you with your emergency at that time. Do we have any non-emergency routine type traffic? Please give your FCC call sign using standard ITU phonetics as well as in plain English, and give your name. All stations duly licensed to operate on this frequency are welcome and encouraged to participate. This time, do we have any announcements for the net? Any announcements? Station following the net, an IF with another station. Hearing no IFs and no announcements, I will move on to short time check-ins. If you would like to be short time, which means you will not stand by later for comments, please do stand by until you've been acknowledged, at which time you'll be free to secure a station as you so choose. I will now take short time check-ins, please.
19, November 9, Tango Lima, Foxtrot, follow.
Quebec, name is Dale. Short time, good evening.
Whiskey Juliet, 9 Echo, WJ9E, Mike, in Rush County, Indiana. Short time, no traffic. Good evening, Joe.
Kilo 509, Delta Delta Oscar, KB9DTO, Earl Madison, no traffic.
KA9WBG, Kilo Alpha 9, Whiskey Bravo Golf, name Sarah, no traffic.
Left, KC9FQ, WJ9E, KB9DDO, and KA9WBG. Good evening to all of you. Any other Showtime stations?
Kilo 9, Romeo Mike Romeo, repeat. K9RMR, Randall M. Ruth, Piersville, Bartholomew County. Good evening, Joe, and everybody on the net.
November 9, Quebec, Victor Oscar, Dave, Shelby County.
R. And I got both of you. Interesting, I caught the tail end of Randall's call after I got Dave's. One more call for short time.
Kilo Delta 9, November, Romeo Zulu, Zurich, Decatur County, no comment.
Time. Hey, thanks to the short timers, and look forward to hearing you again next time. Maybe you'll be regular check-ins. But either way, you're now free to secure a station if you so choose. Let's move on to regular check-ins. This is KA9OPL with the South Central Area Net, and I'll start with suffixes Alpha through Hotel. Stations, the first letter following the number in your call. Alpha through Hotel.
November 9, Charlie Juliet Tango N9CJT, Noel, Bartholomew County. Good evening, Joe.
Kilo Golf Niner, Delta Kilo, KG9DK. Name is John, Miami County. Good evening, Joe, and the group.
Kilo Alpha 9, Echo November Oscar, KA9ENO, Columbus, Bartholomew County. No traffic. Good evening, Joe.
Good evening. I got N9CJT, KG9DK, and KA9ENO. Good evening to all of you. And it is good that we have the repeater back online. Apparently there must have been a power outage out at the site over the weekend when the storms blew through on Saturday. That was the official emergency that we had for field day, I guess. I don't know. But it came back yesterday, so that's a good thing. Any others? Alpha through Hotel. India through Romeo, please.
Whiskey Niner, Romeo, Whiskey Romeo, W9RWR, Rick, Bartholomew County. Good evening, Joe and the net.
A9OPL, this is W9MDT, Whiskey 9, Mike Delta Tango. Mike, Bartholomew County, Columbus.
Alpha Charlie 9 Romeo, AC9R, Chuck in Shelby County.
This is KD9OWO, Mike, Bartholomew County. Hello, Joe.
Kilo Delta 9, Papa Juliet Oscar, KD9PJO, Ashley, Bartholomew County.
Kilo Delta Niner, Papa Papa Whiskey, KD9PPW, Sam, Columbus.
Pleasant surprise, I didn't know you'd still be in town. Good to hear you on there, my friend. W9MDT, Mike, AC9R, Chuck, KD9OWO, Mike, KD9PJO, Ashley, KD9PPW. I believe I got you right, PPW, Papa Papa Whiskey, Sam. Good to hear you on. Guess you got it figured out. Another call, India through Romeo. GR, good evening. Howard got you down. Let's go one more call for the South Central Area Net. Anyone in the alphabet? Anyone anywhere?
AC9, MVK, Rick in Seymour. No comments. Roger, roger.
Okay, and you want to be, did you say short time or you just...
Short time and no comments, sir.
Okay, got you down, Rick. Thank you. One more call. Anyone, anywhere in the alphabet. This is K9OPL, standing by. Okay, we'll go back and we'll take some comments from the list that we have at this point. This is K9OPL with the South Central Area Net. Go back up to the top of the list, N9CJT. Noel, good evening.
Good evening, Joe, and the net. I'll recap something you stated quickly, and that is that the repeater died on Saturday, and the repeater team slowly assembled itself and planned to go out this evening, but the repeater came back up yesterday. The only reasonable explanation is that if Mike, KD9OWO, or Gary, KD9SB, had looked out their window at the tower, they would have seen nothing after dark. We're assuming that the power failed to the tower and that the tower owners, Crown Castle out of Ohio, got the warning and immediately notified the FAA so as to have aircraft avoid the area. And that they got whoever was necessary to restore power to the tower. Ooh, that rhymes. And that person did so, and the repeater came back up as soon as it had juice again. We do have a deep cycle marine battery on the repeater, but it only lasts a very few hours without continuous power. So the group that was planning to go out was, as you know, Joe, you, and me, and Jim N9KVX with his big truck, and Josh, the repeater trustee. Josh got the diversion that he had to attend a birthday party. I'm not sure whose. Let me reset here. And the National Weather Service was predicting all kinds of bad weather for this evening, and so Joe and I decided not to go out, and Jim agreed to haul us out there some other time, maybe when the ground is a lot drier. And that's the status. So we have not swapped in a replacement air conditioner yet, and the repeater will continue to cook as it always has. And that's about all I've got. Good evening again, everyone. This is N9CJT back to net control.
For everybody's benefit, and the only thing I'll add on that topic, excuse me, is that I did test remote access control of the repeater after it came up to make sure we can remotely turn it on and off as is according to regulation, and indeed it does work, so the repeater itself appears to be in good shape. It sounds normal to me right now. The only other comment I'll make is really enjoyed field day the other day with a few of us that gathered together and several coming in and out, which I appreciated. And it was a lot of fun, I thought. It could have been more activity. Some people, you know, we really didn't have a lot of contacts going on, but we did make some. I made several CW contacts, which was kind of fun. And we did enjoy ourselves. Next up, I've got KG9DK, who was the one that showed up out there. Good evening, John.
This is KG9DK. Good evening, Joe and the rest of the group. Yeah, I was planning on coming out and do a walkthrough like that, and I'm certainly glad I carried through on that. Sometimes I have a problem carrying through on some of my plans. But, yeah, I found it interesting and had good conversation there with you about a few things, and I'm glad you all had a good time and enjoyed the situation. Other than that, I've been sort of dodging the raindrops when we have them, but most of the time I'm home and in bed at night. And the way I explain the repeater when it goes off and comes back mysterious like that, or like I'm looking for something in the house and I don't see it, and I go out of the room, come back, and I see it, I blame it on parallel dimension folks wanting to borrow it for a little while. I don't know. It may work for that repeater, too. I don't know. It seems to work for me. Other than that, I've been trying to document some antenna readings that I'm real pleased with. I built a 4-to-1 UNUN from plans off the Internet, and I've been totally amazed with it. So if I get a chance, I'll share my documentation with people. With that, I'll turn it back to you, Joe. It's KG9DK back to net control.
Hey, thank you very much. And John, always appreciate conversations. And yeah, that'll be interesting. That'll be a good topic to bring up to the group at a club meeting, and just share that with people. Maybe we can get it posted on the website. KA9ENO Stewart, good to hear you in there. Good evening. It's your turn.
Good evening, Joe, and to everybody on the net tonight. Sorry I wasn't able to make it on to field day. Ended up having to be out of town. I had to buy some new clothes because I had an interview on Monday morning. Position here in I wanted, but it was going to be my retirement job, which apparently I am going to stay retired and just work a local job and be happy with that. So in the middle of July, I'll be working on the sales floor at Menards. So at least it's something to do, keeps me busy, keeps me out of trouble. So with that, I'll pass it back to you, Joe. This is KA9ENO, back to net control.
Well, very good, Stuart. Well, I'm glad you got something there. And as you said, you know, I think it's always good to keep active, keep busy, and who knows, something else may come along later. But in any case, you've got something now, so that's a good thing. Good to hear you in there, and thank you for being there. W9RWR, Rick, good evening. Good to have you on this evening. It's your turn.
Good evening, Joe and the net. I decided to take a couple of weeks vacation just because I could. And everybody was all upset about the COVID thing, being locked in the house. There's nothing I like better than being locked at the house. So this is a staycation. I'm going to try to get some projects done. I did smoke a brisket the other day, and it turned out much, much better than I expected it to, but I've still got some stuff to learn. And aside from playing radio and watching The Expanse, I'm not doing much. I did get to see Jeff today, briefly, on my way to the grocery store. And it's good to be here, and it's always good to hear your voice, Joe, and everybody else. Glad you all are here. This is W9RWR returning to net control.
Very good, Rick. Thank you much. And it's good to just have some home time sometimes. I've had plenty of that lately, and we do get out once in a while. The wife and I will walk around this community, even if we don't go anywhere, which we sometimes go somewhere, but it's a pretty good community to walk around in, and not a lot of traffic inside here, so that makes it nice. And I've been working from home, so I don't have to go far to go to work. walk into my normal office. W9MDT, Mike, good evening. Your turn.
W9OPL and the net, good evening. This is W9MDT. Yes, participated in field day on Saturday, and had some fun. Didn't make a lot of contacts, but I helped a fellow ham out in getting his HF digital stuff at least along the path of going, and K9JJ helped out some too. Put two antennas up. And, well, actually three, because I helped K9JAJ get his antenna in the tree. And then today, the knot that I swore would, I told Jeff, that knot will not come undone. It came undone this morning, or last night, possibly during the storm. And he was able to get it back up in the air, and he's back online now. But I went back over and trimmed some of his tree for him today. I got to use the air cannon a couple times last week, so that's always a good time. And let's see, I guess that's just about it for me. I'm wondering if the folks in Southwest Indiana have got their water wings on, because I tell you what, when I looked at the radar map first thing this morning, it was absolutely pouring down there, and it rained like that until probably, it looked like to me on the map anyway, on the radar map, that it rained like that pretty much all morning, and gave them maybe an hour and a half of respite, and came again. So, and of course, all that dried up before it got to us. That's both good news and bad news, I guess. But the garden does seem to be wet, and so that's that. I guess we got enough. But anyway, with that, supposed to be some hot days, so if you folks are going to be outside, make sure you drink lots of water, stay hydrated, and take a break every now and then, and stay cool, and be safe. With that, Joe, I'll turn it back to you, KE9OPL, this is W9MDT, back to net control.
Thank you, Mike, and yeah, it was a lot of fun getting together Saturday, and thanks for everything you did getting me over there as well. I appreciated that as always, and yeah, it was fun to work with N9KVX and mess around with his laptop a little bit and get some stuff on there. I think his copy of FD log was working better than mine was. Never did get it working right. Part of that is it's not real friendly with a screen reader. And in the beginning, the trouble I was having with it was I forgot that I had my VPN. I've got a personal VPN, and I had the doggone thing running, which was kind of messing me up. But once I shut that down, I got connected, but I wasn't quite working the way I wanted it to. But we'll figure it out. And I still owe you contacts. I don't know if we're going to do anything with them, Mike, but I'll send them to you anyhow. Well, next up, AC9R, Chuck. Good evening.
AC9R here. Not much going on. I can echo the enthusiasm for staying home. It's my favorite place to be, so I didn't mind at all when they called me from work and said, don't come in. And I'd call in once in a while, and they'd say, nope, stay home. So that was fun. Not a lot going on this evening. I'd be happy to skip the rain for a few days. I think we're going to get to do that. Looks like it might be pretty warm. And that's about all I can think of. So back to net, AC9R.
Very good. Yeah, I think it's going to be more seasonal for the next day or two, and then after that, I guess they're going to turn up the heat. So everybody enjoy it while we got it. And it's going to dry out a little bit, and that's good. We could use that. The other thing interesting that I ordered myself a tripod, a little larger one. I've got a small tabletop one that I use with that Yaesu manual screwdriver antenna that I haven't used a lot lately, but I do have that antenna. I like it. But not always convenient to have to put it on a table, and I have a few other needs for a tripod, so I finally ordered one. Of course, I waited too late, didn't get it in time to play with it on field day. But I'll play with it this weekend. I'm going to take Thursday off, and I get Friday as a holiday. So maybe I'll do a little radio if I don't cook, being outside. So that'll be kind of fun. Well, KD9OWO, Mike, you're up next.
This is KD9OWO. Hello, Joe, and everybody on the net. Not a whole lot going on down here. Getting ready to shoot off some fireworks this week, I guess. Of course, that's my thing this week. So went to field day last weekend, stopped in up there Columbus, said hi to Mike and Joe and Noel and them, and stayed a little while, had another location we wanted to go check out, see how they were doing it, and ended up at home and done a little bit from home. But other than that, not a whole lot going on. Been working on getting some HF tuned in a little better, and finally made a contact to Italy yesterday evening. Heard a station from Italy talking. We hollered at them on our 100 water here and got over to Italy, so that's pretty interesting. But anyways, that's about it. Not much else going on down here. A little bit of rain, a little bit of heat. That's the way it goes in Indiana. If you don't like it, stick around. It'll change here in the next day or two. So I'll get out of here. I think my hot dogs are burning out there on the grill. KD9OWO.
Okay, very good. Well, congratulations on the international contact. Yeah, that's doing it the real way of doing DX, without using the internet. Hi. Of course, I like it both ways, but it's really fun when you do it just purely over the air. Well, the better half, KD9PJO. Your turn, Ashley.
Good evening, Joe, and everybody on the net. It was nice seeing everybody on Saturday. Definitely answered a lot of my questions I had as far as what field day was all about. And like Mike said, later that evening we came home. We decided to try some contesting at our house. And by we, I mostly mean me. I was using his number, but I mean he was observing. And I made quite a few contacts. And then I was like hooked on it, and I like couldn't stop. And I was up late, and I told him, you know, he couldn't go to bed because he had to like be in charge of the station. So, anyways, and then one thing I thought was cool was I can't remember what band I was on, but I heard a station call out another local Columbus ham. I didn't hear him, but I heard the station, so I thought, oh my gosh, what are the odds, you know, that we would be on the same frequency or whatever. So I just thought it was really cool, and yeah, which ended up being Dale, so I had to contact him on the local repeater and say, Dale, I heard him say your number. So I was pretty excited. I thought it was awesome. So Sunday we trimmed a whole bunch of limbs and everything else so we could get some better reception. So anyways, I hope everyone has a great week and a great weekend. Back to you, Joe, KD9OWO. Sorry, KD9PJO. See, I'm stuck from saying his number. KD9PJO.
I was going to say, now, you sounded like Ashley, not Mike. But, hey, that's great. I'm glad you guys did some of that, and that means next year you're going to have to operate with us at field day. And I know you did make a few calls at the field day the other day. I know you. I think you were over at, I don't know whether you're at Jim or I forget which station you're at, but and that's great. Well, I'm glad you guys did that, and congratulations. It's always a lot of fun, and it's field day is great because there's people on that whole 24-hour period. You basically will not find a time, day or night, that you won't hear some signals. That's the great thing about field day. Well, KD9PPW, Sam, welcome and congratulations. I know you're one of our new ones, and good to hear you on there. Good evening. Your turn.
Well, I've been thinking for the last probably 30 minutes now on what I was going to say during my turn, and I still haven't come up with it yet. So, yeah, it's great to have my license. I've made quite a few contacts, mainly around here. I've used Echo Link on my phone a few times to talk to quite a few people a little further out. I got a new truck today. That was nice. Now I'm just trying to figure out how in the heck I'm going to mount ham radios in there. That's pretty much it. I didn't really get to participate in field day this year because I happened to be on vacation all of Saturday and got home late at night, so I didn't really have a chance to go into town and do any field day activities. But yeah, it's great to finally be able to talk on a net and somebody be able to hear me on 2 meters. Sorry, my radio decided it was gonna key out on me. But yeah, it's been a great hobby so far for the last 2 weeks that I've been in it. back to net control, KD9PPW.
Okay, very good. Well, it's certainly welcome aboard, and yeah, good to hear you. You're sounding good. Clear signal into the repeater, and so I'm glad you're getting into it, getting used to it, and learning. That's where the fun comes in. Well, next up, AC9TR. Howard, good evening. Your turn.
Good evening, Joe, and everyone. Nothing much new here, but I say that all the time, so that's probably true. Running a radio into a pickup truck isn't too difficult, especially if it's a Ram, because they used a They allowed a manual transmission. I think they're the last one to allow a manual transmission. So if you've got an automatic, there's an extra hole through the firewall that you can access to run power, ground, and even antenna if you want. So, but if it's a Chevy or Ford, you're probably on your own. Hi, hi. Oh, that's all I got. AC9TR.
All right, very good, Howard. Well, thank you for being there, as always, and always appreciate it. And yeah, there's a, I'm sure every vehicle's a little bit different. Some of them will be a little bit more of an adventure than others. These days, I think one of the challenges with vehicles is they don't have enough metal on them. Kind of hard to put up a good antenna on your vehicle these days, in some cases. Other cases, no problem at all, but... Well, let's see, KC9MBK was short time, and that puts me at the bottom of this list. So, this is KA9OPL with the South Central Area Net, and I'll stand by for any additional check-ins. Please call.
Whiskey Bravo 9, Sierra Mike Charlie, Don.
9JFH, Paul, Westport.
November, N9JFH, is that right?
Affirmative.
Okay, I got you down also, N9JFH. Let's go back to WB9SMC for comments.
Good evening to the group. Good to hear everyone on this evening. Not much to comment on, just trying to stay dry. And had some personal things to take care of Saturday, so I didn't get to play with field day, but got up on Sunday and worked a number of stations on 40 meters using my little 20-watt, not really a QRP, but running on battery power just to see how it would work. And surprisingly, it worked out quite well. And it was good to hear the band. All that activity was almost like the sunspot cycle would come already. But I know it'll get here sooner or later. Wish everyone a happy and safe holiday. Back to you, Joe, WB9SMC.
Hey, very good. Likewise, yeah, everybody have a good Independence Day and remember the many blessings we have of being in a free nation. And I do appreciate that myself. N9JFH, Paul, good evening. It's your turn.
Things have been pretty quiet, at least on the American Red Cross side. I had a false alarm once last week, but anyway, no Red Cross runs, no fires, or at least need bad enough to respond to. Today I was over at the church, built a new ramp, and did some other floor work, and we are ready for brand new carpet. And Lord willing, that'll be coming in Thursday and Friday of this week, and so we're getting pretty excited about that. A little less time to work radio as much as I've been working over at the church, but we're excited about a new sanctuary, and or at least remodeled, and things are looking pretty good. Don't have anything else, and we will, this is N9JFH, we'll return it to net control.
Very good, Paul. Well, good deal. Congratulations on all the progress you've been making at the church there, and I know you're looking forward to having that all completed and ready to work and worship over there, and that's great. I continue to worship, but it'll be kind of nice with the newness over there and getting it all in shape. Well, back again at the bottom of the list, KA9OPL, stand by. If we have any others who would like to join us, please call now. You all at about 9:08 p.m. local time, I will close this net and return the repeater to normal operation. And I'm glad to hear that it's operating normally for after this weekend. Good evening, all 73s. KA9OPL, be clear. Everybody have a good holiday weekend and stay safe. K9OPL 73. N9CJT, hello Noel, K9OPL.
Pick a simplex frequency if you have a minute to do that, and I'd like to have you use your ears to tell me which which setting on this thing sounds better. You have time for that?
Sure. Let's see. What do you think? 146.49 or something like that?
Yeah, I think I've got that one in here. So catch you there at 9 CJT. Thanks.
Okay, K9OPL, QSY.